Vast talk will be by Paolo Shiba from Kyoto University, and he will talk about TTIPA information and power peace.
Okay, so thank you for the introduction. So, I want to appreciate Chung-Sun's report for organizing for this wonderful production on the preparing APC of the power peace. So, yeah, thank you so much. So let me begin with my talk. So here, I'd like to talk about the recent progress on TTIPA information and its programming interpretations. So this is just an overview talk. So I gave the same talk at YATP 3 weeks ago. If you have heard this talk before, so please take a nap for 3 minutes. Okay, so anyway, so let me begin with my talk. So here, main subject is these two things. So the first one is the information of two-dimensional quantum field theories, especially we are interested in two-dimensional performance field theories here. So here, so everything is two-dimensional field theories. So we are we don't consider high-dimensional setups. And of course, consider the high-dimensional work gravity world for these things. And so this is the second one. So we are interested in gravity world for gravity world two-dimensional performance field theories. So actually, so in the recent years, so we got a lot of papers for this subject, but there are some confusions. So here, I'd like to try to remove some confusions from the papers. Okay, so anyway, so this is a very concise review. This is a review by Jian for this paper. This is a very nice review. So if you are interested in these subjects, please take a look. Okay, so then let me begin with the introduction. So here, I'd like to introduce the basics on the TTIPA information by using five slides. Okay, so what is TTIPA information? So here, let's assume the set of two-dimensional quantum field theories described by the Grandjean. Okay, so we assume the Grandjean description for the theories. So then, consider trajectories in the theory space parameterized by constant parameter alpha. Okay, so for constant parameter alpha, Lagrangian is attached. So then, denote the Lagrangian at each point of the trajectory by L alpha. So then, the flow for theories around the trajectory is triggered by independent operators defined by this one. So this is just the return term of energy modulus tension at each point alpha. So then we may consider infinitesimal deformation of constant parameter alpha to alpha plus del alpha. So del alpha is an infinitesimal parameter. And so here we are considering the return term operator here. So delta alpha has a dimension length scale. So this is the independent operator. Okay, so anyway, so these Lagrangian can be expanded like this. So anyway, so this is a different partition here to here. So this operator is called a TTIPA operator. So this operator is written into this form. So this T and T bar is the usual T and T bar. So GG component and G bar component of energy modulus tensors. But determinant cleaning U contains presence of the energy momentum tensor, TTT bar, theta square here. But still, we will call these operators TT bar operators. So this is the conventions in the subject. So anyway, so here, so we have not assumed anything for the uniform theory. So we can consider TT bar information for any two-dimensional conformal field, any two-dimensional quantum field theory. So if we take conformal field theories as uniform theories, so here I have this contact here. And so this may be regarded as a relevant perturbations around this IR fixed point. So anyway, so this depends on the choice of uniform theory. Okay. So anyway, so this TTIPA operator has a very nice properties. So this is the factorization of expectation value of TTIPA operators. So this nice property was discovered by Sasha Zamolchikov originally in his papers in 2004. So this is a factorization equation. So this factorization is valid without taking Gaussian limit or taking BPS limit. So this is quite remarkable properties. And this expression value can be taken for non-degenerate stationary states beyond ground states. So this factorization is very strong. So anyway, so we need to assume some conditions to show this factorization. Okay, so let me explain the conditions for this factorization. The first one is local translational and rotational invariance. This is a local condition. So this condition assumes ensure the existence of local energy momentum tensor TMU and symmetricity of TMU. Okay? So then the second one is a global translational invariance. This is a global condition. And so then the exception value of any local field OI does not depend on the coordinate G. So it becomes constant. So this condition is also important. And the third one is infinite separations. So this is also a global condition. So there should exist at least one direction should be infinitely long in order such that these operations can be well defined. So by combining the condition 2 and 3, so the basically three-dimensional base space is infinite plane or infinitely long cylinder. So these conditions are very important for this factorization. Okay? So then the fourth condition is shifting limit at short distances. So this is a local condition. So in order to make conditions of typical operators are ambiguous, so this condition should be imposed. So anyway, so under these assumptions, such as the Zamolchikov succeeded in showing this factorization. So anyway, so this factorization is quite striking. Okay, so very striking. And then we'd like to consider applications of this factorization. So let's consider two-dimensional quantum field cell. Quantum field cell is on an infinitely long cylinder. So in the following, tau is the time direction and x is compactified with a dial, capital L. Okay? So this is an infinitely long cylinder. So then, so here we are interested in long cylinders rather than the infinite plane. Because, so if we consider infinite plane, the excitation value of P or P bar does vanish. And so that's why so you have to consider non-vanishing P and T bar. So we are interested in long cylinders instead of infinite plane. Okay? So then the factorizations enables us to compute the excitation value of T bar operators. So with an arbitrary non-degenerate eigenstates of the energies and kept defined by this one as usual. So then we can evaluate excitation value of T bar operators like this. So then, by using the physical meaning of the stress tensors, so we can rewrite these equations in terms of energy and relative energy and momentum on the compactified directions. So that the capital component of the energy momentum tensors corresponds to energy densities, and the XX component corresponds to pressure, and the X component corresponds to momentum density. So these components of the energy momentum tensors has physical meaning. And so we can rewrite this expression in terms of the physical quantities, energy and momentum. Okay, so this was shown by Sasha Zamolchikov in 2004. So then, so Sviridrapan Zamolchikov and Roberto Tadeor and his collaborators proposed TT bar flow equations by this one. So this is a key ingredient in our other discussion. So anyway, this is the TT bar flow equations proposed by Zen. So then let's evaluate these TT bar flow equations by using the previous results, introducing the previous slides. So by taking the expectation value of this TT bar flow equation, so we can get this expression. then, so the right-hand side point is how we evaluated in the previous slide already. So we can rewrite, we can express this quantities in terms of energy and momentum. So then, we can get the fourth indices Barber's equation. So this is the derivation of Barber's equations based on the optimization of the TD operators and flow equations proposed by them. Okay. So anyway, so this Barber's equation is very interesting. So because distinct differential equations can control the development of energy eigenvalues. So we can get the energy spectrum for the Lyapunov system, TD Lyapunov system, by solving this Barber's equation. Exactly. So okay, so this is the statement for the Barber's equation. So by solving the Barber's equations, we can get the spectrum for the TD Lyapunov system.
How do we get PN to EN?
PN to EN.
Yeah, then you can solve it.
Actually,
so PN is unknown.
PN is fixed.
So PN, how is it?
So PN is just given by the input. So initial data is.
So PN doesn't depend on alpha?
Yeah, yes, yes. So that is fantastic. Yeah. PN is independent of alpha.
PN depends on alpha.
PN depends on alpha, yes.
But PN is what?
I think that in this context, PN is independent of alpha.
Or what is that?
Solving the Barber's equations, we can obtain the energy spectrum for the TD Barber's Lyapunov system. And also then, so one has to ignore the original spectrum EN as the input. So then, so we can give the input for the differential equations. And so then, by solving these equations, we can get the exact expression for the energy spectrum of TD Barber's Lyapunov system. So that's why so we are interested in more field theories or integral quantum field theories as an input. So then we can get the expression of the energy spectrum by solving this equation. Okay. So but even if the original spectrum is unknown, the deformation effect itself can be examined by solving this equation. So in this sense, this integral deformation is called integral deformation. So that this integral deformation is really integral formation in the usual sense, as explained in the next slide. So anyway, so this is the integral deformation. I mean, so this formation is the integrability in the usual sense. And so then, the form reduction can also be obtained by solving these integral equations somehow. So here I don't explain how to compute the form reduction, but for example, if we consider a Riemann's series as a form theory, so then we can get the number of actions as a TD by Lyapunov system. And so the alpha prime, the positive string tension, is given by the deformation parameter alpha. So alpha has a dimension length square. So that corresponds to alpha prime, roughly speaking. So information parameter corresponds to information parameters. On the same, so we can take arbitrary value of information parameters. And so if you consider alpha to infinity limit, so then corresponds to alpha prime to infinity limit. So that means a tensionless limit. So then, so mass scalar can be pointed to the higher spin field segments or something. So anyway, so by considering the divided formations, we can find some stringy actions. So this is quite interesting property. Okay. So anyway, so let me make a small comment on the divided formation of two-dimensional integral integrable quantum field segments, like sine quantum model or Bayes delta model. So indeed, the T-divided formation is really integral formation of relativistic integral quantum field surface in dimension of four. In relativistic integral case, it is well known that the n-body S matrix is factorized to the product of the two-body S matrices. So this is the concept of the quantum integrabilities of this system, as is well known. So then, the two-body S matrix can be determined from the assumptions, Lorentz symmetries, unitarities, and Cauchy symmetries, and Lambert equations for the scattering S matrix. So then, so we can fix the two-body S matrix up to the CDD factor. So this is also a very known procedure, the so-called S matrix bootstrap. So anyway, so we can determine two-body S matrix up to the CDD factors. And so then, so I'd like to introduce the following fact. So electron deformations can form only the CDD factors. So actually, the mass spectrum for all deformation should be the incorrect information. So, but electron deformation can change UV deformation, UV region only. So I have the other region is not deformed. So that's why. So this one deformation can deform only the CDD factor. So this is the fact shown by this paper. So anyway, so CDD deformation is a special example of relevant deformation. So CDD deformation can deform only the CDD factor. So in this sense, this optimization of this process is preserved. So in this sense, CDD deformation is an integral deformation. The usual sense. Okay, so this is the established fact for the divided formation. So okay, so this from my talk. So first of all, I'd like to introduce the divided formation of two-dimensional homomorphic field series. So I'd like to show you the interact spectrum of the divided homomorphic field series. Find more infinitely long sheeter. So then, I'd like to explain the behavior of entropies in the D-divided homomorphic field series. So these properties are very important to get some ideas for the graph D-divers or D-divided homomorphic field series. So then, I'd like to explain the progress on graph D-diver or D-divided homomorphic field series. So actually, so we need to consider two kinds of gravitational divers for the divided homomorphic field series, depending on the signature of the deformation parameters. For the positive sign, so the diver is given by RG flow type solutions from the 16 solid to ABS version graph hole. And for the negative sign, so we need to consider cutoff ABS. So probably this part of ABS geometry is more popular over the something. So yeah, probably so you have heard that you have heard this part. Okay, so anyway, so I'd like to explain these subjects in the following. Any questions so far?
So far, the TN. Part and diagonalize the P. But why can't also diagonalize the energy for home alpha?
Oh, that was in yeah. Also, you mean to. So, EN is diagonalized as the initial data, right? So, then.
But I thought you choose the operator P. diagonalize the P, because you want to specify P and fix P. And then P is no longer diagonalized.
PN is, PN should be fixed, so it's indexed. So PN is a compact by one square or something.
So you already fixed the diagonalization.
Yeah. That is fixed for the all of the process.
And is E also diagonalized?
EN? So EN is diagonalized as the input, right? So we take the energy eigenvalue and energy eigenstates to evaluate the BTB operator. So then the evolution of the evolution of the energy spectrum using the differential equation. So that diagonalization is preserved. So of course energy spectrum should be formed continuously by changing alpha. But there is no level crossing, and so yeah, such behaviors have been confirmed numerically, at least numerically before. Anyway, so yeah, of course we need some arguments for observations of diagonalization.
Did you assume that you maintain translation invariance?
Yeah.
And then P is guaranteed to be commutative with that energy.
Okay, that's the explanation. That is a translation invariant.
Because you do assume that, right? You need to.
Yeah. So, yes, I'm here. Okay, so, the assumptions are made by Sasha is very important to consider for some parts of this analysis. In some works, such conditions are not preserved, so we should be careful for the validity of the results. But anyway, so any other question? Okay, so then let me continue my talk. So here, so I'd like to explain each of the combination of two major conformal field theory by probing these two similar papers by Sinner and Samochkov and the loops of error and the operators. Okay, so let's pause. Okay, so let's consider each evaluation of conformal field series defined on infinitely long cylinders with diodes capital L. So then let's take the conformal data, the initial conformal data for primary fields, this one. So then by using these data, we can solve the Fagas equation, and so the resulting energy spectrum is given by this one. So here, I introduce a new quantity small p, so this is the dimensional combination of alpha and x square. This is the dimensionless information parameter. Okay, so when alpha is equal to zero, the original spectrum is reproduced, of course. So this is the typical form energy spectrum. So then, so here, we should be careful for the signature of the coupling alpha. So alpha is positive case is called cosine, alpha is negative case called plus sine. So this terminology was introduced by Leon Dalian because of his papers. So yeah, anyway, so it's not my terminology, but positive is good, and so negative is bad. So this is the terminology. So you may find that the signature of the differential parameter is so significant. So actually, you may wonder why the signature of the coupling should be significant. So for example, let's consider calculating the force theory in four dimensions. So then, we may find on your own this system by adding this term onto this action. So if alpha is positive, potential is still bounded and the vacuum is still stable. But if alpha is negative, the potential is not bounded anymore. So the vacuum something becomes unstable. So you can easily understand that. Understand that. So the signature of the coupling constant is very sensitive for the features. So anyway, so that's why so we should be careful for the signature of the deformation parameter alpha. Okay, so anyway, so this is just a simple explanation of the significance of the signature of the deformation parameter. So okay, so then let's see the properties of the deformed energy spectrum. So for CPHD, let's consider the ground state partaking in this condition. So then the energy is simplified to this form. And so from this equation, so we can see the upper bound from the central charge C. So in order to make energy real, so we need to include this condition. So then, so this upper bound seems to be problematic in dealing for the gravitational dual. Because when we consider the gravity dual, we like to take large N limit or large C limit, and so this upper bound seems to be problematic. So we need to consider something. And possible resolutions as proposed by Kimeo and Misaki Tassov in his papers. So by taking a two root like limit, as it's an infinity and meeting zero, while BC is less than 6.
And so we are going to see infinity. So if you start from C equal 1 half using model.
C equal 1 half
is using model.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So then what happens to the So what happens to the new deformed model?
Oh, new deformed
model is still conformal, right?
Not conformal.
Oh, not conformal.
Yeah, conformal should be conformal.
I have also a naive question about that. Is the L dependent to this purely in the L at the front?
LUTDB corresponds to that limit, yes.
Excuse me, I can't.
LUTDB corresponds to that limit, that's the flat space.
Is the only dependent of L in that formula the 2 pi over L?
The energy is something proportional to 1 over L. Right?
And this looks like the scaling for a conformal theory, right?
So still you say it's not conformal.
Yeah, I think so, yeah. But conformal is easy by definition, so conformal symmetry is probably.
Yeah, but the energy is proportional to 1 over L. Right?
Yeah, it seems to be contradicting.
I think so, this is, because the internality, so it should be proportional to 1 over L.
There are also other parameters in B and B, so the definition is for B contains the dimension of the parameter.
Oh, yeah. So some argument for the validities for these cardioformular expressions. But anyway, so yeah, some argument probably done. So by following the argument, so here we will maybe follow this cardioformula. So then, so we can revise this expression to this one. So we got the reformed energy spectrum here. So by solving this expression in terms of Mn, so then so we can rewrite Mn in terms of En. So then we can put Mn here. So then we can get this expression. Okay. So then, so of course, this is valid at high energy region. So Cali E should be much larger than one. So for Cali E is much less than 1 over B, so the entropy of the original compound fuel cell is recovered, of course. So we can drop off this term, and so this is the original entropy. So on the other hand, so there is an interesting limit. So that is Cali E is much larger than 1 over B. So this is limited to the delivered compound fuel cell. So then, entropy is approximated to this expression. So interestingly, the entropy is proportional to energy. So this is something like a hadron-like behavior. And so this is something like a hadron-like behavior. And so this part expresses the inverse of the hadron temperature. And actually, so this behavior is very characteristic to the Dickey-Barge homomorphic theory. And actually, so Cleon, Microsoft, and they are the experts on reducing theories. And actually, so this behavior is exhibited in reducing theories as well. So, of course, they know well this agreement. So, they got ideas for gravitational fever. So, the UV regions should be described as reducing theories, and the IR region is still usual radius for IS graph code. So, this is ideas for the gravitational fever. After observing the behavior of the energy spectrum on entropy. Okay, so anyway, so this is observations for the gravitational giver based on the Dickey-Barge bond homomorphic series. So here, so far, so we have considered the positive alpha. So here we have to consider the negative alpha case. So of course, so we can consider, we may consider negative alpha, right? So then, so as far as we see the ground states, so there should be no problem for large CD for negative alpha case. But in the negative case, there should be some problem for energy for highly excited states instead of the ground states. So that is the problem. So this is the energy, this is the energy for the excited states. So then, so let's see this square root part. So if we consider the high energy case, so inside of the square root becomes negative, and so the energy becomes imaginary again. So we should be careful for the inside of this square root. So this square root means that so we need to introduce a capital for the energy itself, like this. So then, so according to this capital, we need to put a capital for the entropy like this. So these observations led Fermi network to propose a cutoff radius geometries. So just by cutting off the UV regions of radius geometries, we can report these upper bounds for energy and entropies. So that's why, so by observing the behavior of energies in the Dickey-Barge bond homomorphic field theory, so they got an idea of cutoff radius geometries. Okay. So this is the observation for the negative alpha case. Okay, so anyway, so this is the observations for the gravitational quarks based on some quantities in Dickey-Barge bond homomorphic field theory.
Okay, wait. That's the first thing. In this case, okay, for alpha being equal to zero, I would just expect normal ABS CFT.
Alpha equals zero, yes.
And then I just turn on alpha a little bit, and it changes very dramatically. So I get a little string theory, but somehow it seems to be very discontinuous.
Yeah, yeah. And actually, so there should be something to be explained. Actually, there is another gap between the classifier and finding the world. So yeah, probably so actually explain. Okay, so anyway, so based on the observations obtained from the T-T-Value-Form over a few series, we would like to discuss graphic words or T-T-Value-Form over a few series by drawing these papers. Okay, so first of all, let's consider the positive alpha case. So this case is based on this paper mainly. So here, we are interested in ADS system with NSNSPP. And this system is exactly solvable. This system was registered by these people. So then, of course, the full background is ADS3 times S3 times T4. And this background can be realized as a universal limit of KNS pipelines and P fundamental strings wrapped on five-dimensional Minkowski step time, S1, and time T4. More precisely speaking, so NS pipelines extends to time direction and S1 and T4, and fundamental string extends to time direction and that S1. Okay, so then, after taking the universal limit, this time direction and S1 and the direction here describe ADS3 geometry. So anyway, so we can get ADS3 geometries by taking a scaling limit for this plane computation. And the ADS radius is given by this quantity. So this is a standard setup for the ADS3 shifted zoom based on the NSS zoom on the model complex. Okay, so let me introduce a relevant perspective of this ADS3 shifted zoom. So large P, the boundary for a few series in this setup has a here form. So this is a symmetric product structures. So at large P, so the boundary for a few series is factorized to this form. So each carry n corresponds to a few series. So here we consider P fundamental strings. So each fundamental string corresponds to carry n. So compound theory corresponds to each fundamental string. So then, so this is the symmetric group. So this is something like a symmetric product. So anyway, so at large P, this symmetric product structure appears according to this according to these papers. So then, so each n is a compound field theory with central charge 6k. So the total central charge is P times this one. So the total central charge is 6k. Okay, so roughly speaking, so this carry n can be regarded as a compound field theory associated with a single fundamental string. So this symmetric product structure relies on the process at large P. The interaction between the fundamental strings vanishes like this. So the string coupling, the square of string coupling is proportional to 1 over p. So at large p, this string coupling becomes 0. So that's why. So we can see the this symmetric product structures are for fundamental strings. Okay, so this is a relevant perspective for our other discussion. So here, based on the symmetric product structures, we can introduce two types of TTV operators. So this is a gap which we have to, I hope to explain. So the first one is a double trace TTV operators. So we should take the summation for P to B for carry N. So then we should take a product. So this is called the double trace TTV operators. So this is this corresponds to the usual T-T-bar definition, but so this double trace T-T-bar operators leads to the non-local definition of the string pulse shift. So this is the point. So this is a double trace T-T-bar operator. So gentle one is a single trace T-T-bar operator. So the product is taken first. So then the summation is taken. So this is a single-threaded operator. So this is different from double-threaded operator. change this TTV operator in the study. Yeah, so this change this TTV operator corresponds to current information of the three mod seats in ABS3. So this JJ bar definition, this current definition is for the JJ bar definition. So this JJ bar definition has been well studied in the old literatures. So this is something like a recycle of the old results or revival of the old results. So anyway, so this JJ bar definition of the three mod seat is well known. So decided to consider graphic work for the shift-based GDB operators, so not the first GDB operators. So in this sense, so the analysis is slightly different from the usual GDB operators. Okay? So, but anyway, so in this case, so we can make some big applications for the open results and we can get some new insights for the open results. So anyway, so in the following, we will consider the gravitational lever for these GDB operators. And actually, so as far as I know, the gravity lever for the double GDB operators with positive sign has not been discussed.
Well,
but I will come to this point at the end of my talk. Okay, so then, so what is the gravity lever for single GDB operators? With positive sign. So from the behavior of the energy and entropy in the GDB decomposable field theory, so gravity dual should describe RC flow type solution, and UV region should be described by UCA theory, and the other region should be the usual NDSV. So, and the associated gravity solution was already constructed before, and so in this case, so this type of type solution of this type was constructed already. So but in the following, so we are interested in the final temperature version of this solution. And actually the final temperature version was already constructed as well by Sanjian Xiang. So he's a Korean researcher and one of my friends. So okay, so he constructed the solution in 1997. So anyway, so this is the solution, and this is just a three dimensional part. And so we are not interested in the three dimensional internal space. So here we will focus on the three dimensional BDS part. Okay. So this metric contains some constant parameters, but R1 is given by EK and the fundamental constant. So R1 is not so important. And so R0 is constant parameter measure the temperature. So R0 equals 0 corresponds to the zero temperature case. Okay? So that one is enough. Okay, so anyway, so the R0 is important in the discussion. And X1 direction should be compactified on a sample with Galileo's capital M like this. Okay, so then let's see the behavior of these solutions. So the R20 limit corresponds to the IR limit. So the solution becomes a three-dimensional ADS shield black hole, as usual. So, okay, so then there's a problem. And so R20 limit corresponds to the UV limit. And the same theory is realized. So then, so by evaluating the Bryson area, we can get Zekenshine-Hawking entropy like this. So this is the expression of Zekenshine-Hawking entropy. So then, let's suppose these solutions between R0 and Kali E. So Kali E is the energy in the T-body form field theory. So in this case, so the temperature case corresponds to the ground state E equals 0. Temperature is proportional to energy from the compact field theory side. So, anyway, so in the following, we suppose simulations. Okay. So then, the entropy can be written into this form. Okay. So then, so on the other hand, the Kali formula is similarly, but B. So, and remember the product structure of the bounded conformal field series at large B. So this is the symmetric product of the bounded conformal field series. So then, so now we assume that Q twist is equal to predators. And so we can evaluate the entropies for each curly M conformal field series. So then the entropy is given by this one. So then, so we need to take account of P copies of curly M. So the total entropy is given by this one. So then, by assuming this relation, we can see the exact agreement for the entropies. Okay. So anyway, so this alpha is proportional to alpha prime and 1 over P. So P to infinity limit corresponds to the uniform cell. That is the P to infinity limit corresponds to the usual Bayes geometry. And so Bayes geometry is taken as an uniform parameter in this sense. And the dimension of the dimension parameter is explained by alpha prime. So then, let me explain about the gravity equal with negative sign. So this part is based on the Pauling integral tuples. So here, the index is in the three-dimensional action gravity plus negative cosine of the constant as usual. And so the index is in the usual Euclidean BDT graph with mass n and angular moment of j. So this is the usual Euclidean BDT graph. But the difference is the location of the boundary. So here, we have to consider the cutoff radius based on the observations obtained from the behavior of entropy and energy spectra. And so we put some cutoffs at finite largest position, R equal RC, for example. So RC is the location of the boundary. Okay? So we want to consider cutoff radius geometries here. So then, we want to compute the boundary energies by using this cutoff radius geometry. So here, we are interested in the Kessler local energy introduced by this author. So this is the expressions of energies at the finite largest positions. So then, so energy momentum tensor is represented by its energy curvature here J. So these are the normal vectors included here. So then, it is useful to introduce the proper size of the spatial sample on the boundary. So the x1 direction should be compactified on sample with value of capital L. Capital L is described as the proper size of the spatial sample. And so then, so by this metric independence, so RC appears here. So the location of the cutoff is related to the size of sample. So this is by contrary relation, but by using this relation, we can see the relation between capital L and the finite location of the boundary is at finite largest position. Okay. So then the energy can be evaluated like this. So this F is work factors included in the BDG black hole metric. And so then we can get this square root part. So actually, so this square root part appears in the energy spectrum of the GT value on conformal field theory, right? Actually, the square root has a very simple origins in the BDG black hole. This is just nothing but the work factors. So we can explain the origin of this square root as the work factors in the BDG black hole. So this derivation is very beautiful. Actually, so this derivation is not only towards ones, but the plus ones. So the plus equal derivation is very sophisticated. And so the origin of the scale root is very clear. Okay, so then, so by imposing these derivations, we can see the exact agreement for the energy spectrum. And actually, so here, four conditions, a correlation here. But the last two are not new. These are the usual one. The context of Bayes' BCP2. So new ones are the first two. So for example, the first one implies that the condition parameter is proportional to Newton constant and to curvature radius. So anyway, so the condition parameter is measured as a Newton constant. And so of course, and capital L is related to the locations of the boundary at finite radius of C. Okay, so anyway, so this is just one example of the supports for the cutoff radius, and there are other supports for the cutoff radius geometry. So I would not like to explain these things. And so intergrouping entropies in the cutoff radius geometry is very popular. So out of papers are revisions for this subject. So this is the list of the papers. So anyway, so the intergrouping formula works well even for the emergent case. So it should be nice to check the radiation correspondence even for the emergent cases. Okay, so then let me summarize my talk. So here, I have introduced the recent progress on the evaluation and its programming interpretations. So actually, so the depending on the signature of the recognition parameters, so I have introduced two kinds of gravitational duals. And actually, so the first one, for the positive case, so the Feynman dual considers the single place, not double place operators. So that is a difference between the definition of the operators. And so we need to consider the double place operators for the positive sign. But there may be another interesting stories proposed by Vika and Monten. So this possibilities may be very large. So of course, so single boundary conditions at finite bulk radius can be regarded as mixed boundary conditions at infinity. So based on these papers. So by following the statement, so this bulk radius may be large. So this is a proposal made by Vidal Fonte. So then, so they propose that the mixed boundary conditions can express gravity duals for both signs for double twisted operator. So actually, so I have not read the papers carefully. I'm not sure for the validity of this paper from statement. But anyway, so this proposal should be very interesting to explain gravity duals for both signs with double twisted operator. So have time? So yeah, probably yeah, I should finish here. Thank you.
One word. What happens when you switch an alpha?
So when alpha, so alpha is small, it's more, or I don't know. So the big gap for the gravitational duals, and so
what happens? So if alpha is zero, you have just a two condition. Zero.
Yes, yes.
And once you switch to alpha, then it suddenly becomes
probably so alpha corresponds to alpha prime, yeah. So alpha prime corresponds to the square of the same scale. Yeah. So I don't know, so how should we consider
your
Oh, I'm just saying. So.
Thank you, everyone.
Yeah. Anyway, so yeah, I'd like to thank for all the participants for coming to this lecture. So as Johnson said on the first day, so this is the first time to co-organize this workshop in Shinju. So of course we can organize some workshop in Kyoto, but this is the first time, so it should be a memorial workshop for us. And so we are forward. So this communication program should be sustainable, and so I hope that we could continue this communications for a long time.
Hope to see you, some of you, maybe not all of you, but some of you, and meet you again in any series of meetings.
Yeah, so, yeah, thank you so much. Thank you for coming.